George was strolling alone through the darkening passageway of that forest after a long, tiring day, when he felt some masked faces hurriedly approaching towards him. Within no time, they came closer. Before George could run for his life, one of these men abruptly grasped George's right hand and put a special chain onto it. A mask was put on his face as he tried to yell out loudly. He tried to punch them with his left hand, but was quickly overpowered by one of these men. He then chained the George's left hand as well. One of those men then quickly picked up an old rusty chainsaw stained with blood. He used this chainsaw to cut the George's body into two halves. George's muffled wails in agony were enough to disturb the quietude of the forest. One of these devilish thugs magically transformed the left half of George's corpse into right half. The same George who was happily rambling in the forest a few moments back was now lying on the same land, divided into two congruent blood-stained parts. Now I will remove one of these parts, as whatever happens to this part, the same thing will happen onto that part as well. One of those lusty rascals then searched the pocket of the corpse and found a bank check which he stole. He also attached a special chain onto it. The chain had special magnetic capabilities that it could pull a coin that once the George had owned. The next robber came forward and removed the chain in order to obtain that coin. Poor George's corpse was now left with a chain attached onto its right side. Another fussy robber then shifted the chain to the center of the body. Their story of lust does not end here. One of them then squeezed the dead body. Now that the energy was concentrated to this central chain, a robber came forward to remove the chain, thus obtaining the energy in the form of a coin. In the end, we are left with two squeezed halves of the body, with two coins and a bank check from each half. So what this story has to do with glycolysis? Let me tell you. In this story, in this analogy, the forest is actually the cytosol of cell in which these reactions of glycolysis occur. And this man George is actually a 6-carbon sugar called glucose. In first step, this robber or enzyme attaches a phosphate to the right hand of George. So energy as well as the chain, the phosphate is obtained by breaking down ATP, and thus the glucose with phosphate attached to its 6-carbon, so we form glucose 6-phosphate. And the enzyme which has kinase activity for glucose, it is called glucokinase, as well as it has another form called hexokinase. In second step, what happens that the robber put a mask on the George. So this is like converting the glucose 6-phosphate into its isomeric form. So the enzyme which is involved is isomerase, and because this enzyme is acting on phosphoglucose, we call it phosphoglucose isomerase. In third reaction, the chain, the phosphate, is also attached to the other half. of course, ATP is being utilized in this process. And enzyme which has kinase activity for phosphofructose, it is called fructokinase 1. And the substance, the product which is formed, which is having chain at carbon number 1, phosphate at carbon number 1, as well as at carbon number 6. This is called fructose 1,6 bisphosphate. In this reaction, a robber cuts the jaws into two parts with a chainsaw. So this is just like removing, this is just like cutting the fructose 1,6 bisphosphate from the center. And the enzyme which is required is called aldolase. So we obtain two products. One is dihydroxyacetone phosphate, which is having phosphate attached to carbon number 1. So this is dihydroxyacetone phosphate. And the other product which we obtain is having the phosphate attached to its carbon number 3. So this is called glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. Glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. In this reaction, a robber magically convert this part into this one. So that is, it means that it converts the dihydroxyacetone phosphate into glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. So because glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate are isomers of each other, so this enzyme which interconvert them through a reversible reaction is called isomerase. So now we have two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. So we have two glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. From now on, I will only discuss the reaction which occurs with this glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. And of course, you must understand this, that whatever reaction that happens with this glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, the same events also occurs with this glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. So in next reaction, in this reaction, what happens that this robber, one of the robber, it will come forward and it will search the pocket of this George, the dead body of George. And it will attach a chain, a special chain onto it. So the check, why I am calling it check, because some hydrogen is removed from glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, from the functional group of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, hydrogen is removed, and this hydrogen is added to NAD positive to form NADH. So what we get? We get the bank check NADH as well as 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate. I am calling it 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate. I am not calling it 1,3 bisphosphoglyceraldehyde, because hydrogen is removed from its functional group. It is no more glyceraldehyde. It is now glycerate, because it is no more aldehyde. Its hydrogen is removed. So we obtain 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate as well as NADH in this process. And the enzyme which removes the hydrogen from glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, this enzyme is called glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate dehydrogenase. And of course, it is also attaching a phosphate chain onto carbon number 1. And this phosphate chain, because it is a dead body, energy is not utilized in this process in the form of ATP. It uses the inorganic phosphate. It uses the phosphate from inorganic phosphate to be attached here. No ATP is being used in this process. In next reaction, what happens that this chain is removed. So when this chain is removed, we get a coin. What is the coin? Coin is the energy currency. That is, we obtain ATP. So now from 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate, phosphate is being removed from carbon number 1. and of course ATP is obtained. So the product which is formed is 3-phosphoglycerate, and the enzyme is phosphoglycerate kinase. So next, a fussy robber shifts the position of phosphate to the center of body. This robber mutates the position of phosphate. So from 3-phosphate, from carbon number 3, the phosphate is shifted to, phosphate is mutated to carbon number 2. So the enzyme which mutates the position of phosphate, this is called phosphoglycerate mutase. It's called mutase, and because it is acting on phosphoglycerate, we call it phosphoglycerate mutase, and this is a reversible reaction. Now a robber picks up this dead body, this part of dead body, and squeezes it. So we get phosphoenol pyruvate as well as some water molecules. And the energy is now concentrated into this central phosphate chain, and the enzyme is enolase. You can remember this phosphoenol pyruvate or PEP. You can remember this PEP by correlating it with a bottle of Pepsi Cola. So just remember that we obtain a bottle full of water. So phosphoenol pyruvate is formed as well as some water is obtained. And of course the energy is concentrated into this central phosphate chain. In last reaction, a robber will come forward to remove this phosphate chain, thus obtaining a quine from this dead part of the George. So enzyme is pyruvate kinase, and we obtain what? We obtained pyruvate as well as an ATP molecule. So this is the summary of all the steps of glycolysis. Now from here, from the starting up to here, you can see that we are not getting any energy in the form of ATP. Rather, we are investing the energy in the form of ATP. So this is the energy investment phase. And from here onward, we are getting the energy in the form of ATP as well as NADH, in the form of ATP as well as NADH. So this is the energy payoff phase. This is just like doing a business, that in doing the business, first we invest the money, and then there is, after some time, we get the money back. The money is paid off in the form of profit. So of course, from this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, the similar reactions also happens with this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So ultimately, we obtain 1, 2, 3, and 4. So ultimately we obtain 4 ATP molecules directly, and we obtain 2 NADH. But 2 ATP molecules are also utilized during this process. So how many net ATP we directly obtain? Total 4 ATP. And out of these 4 ATP molecules, 2 are utilized. So net ATP which we obtain directly are 2 ATP molecules. And of course, we are also getting 2 NADH. 2 NADH molecules. And from each NADH molecules, we obtain 3 ATP molecules. So 2 multiplied by 3 is equal to 6. So total, how many ATP molecules net, how many ATP molecules we are getting? 6 plus 2 is equal to 8. So net, we are getting 8 ATP molecules during the process of glycolysis. So this is how you can memorize the glycolysis with the help of a simple visual story, a horror story. I hope you like this video. If so, please press the thumbs up button. And please do consider subscribing my channel and press the bell icon. Thank you for watching.